Flake speaking with Julian Stephens this morning from Sovereign Metals. Julian, morning.
Morning, Andrew. How are you going?
Yeah, good, Julian. Big morning for you. The pre-feasibility study results out for Kasiya. Look, firstly, has it met expectations?
It absolutely has. We have produced a study with a very long mine life, $415 million US EBITDA over 25 years, $1.6 billion NPV. It will be the largest rutile producer in the world at about 220,000 tonnes a year of rutile and one of the largest graphite producers in the world as well.
And of course, Julian, this study, this only uses around, what, a third of the existing resource?
That's right. So we only converted about a third of the resource, or about 30% really, to reserves for this study. The resource is, as you know, it's huge, being the biggest in the world at 1.8 billion tonnes. This study only uses about 540 million tonnes of that. So there's plenty of additional resource there that we could convert to reserves in future to either increase production rates or increase the mine life, possibly to, let's say, maybe 50 years or longer.
And where does the project sit from an environmental and social perspective?
Yeah, so environmentally, well, it will be a very low carbon emitter, one of the lowest in the world, in fact, for industrial minerals, because we're able to use green energy, renewable energy, solar and hydropower to power the majority of the operation. In terms of these more environmental footprint, well, like most mineral sands mines, we'll be mining out these pits, then backfilling with tails, drying them and rehabilitating them as we go, and returning that land to farming or other uses.
And we have spoken about this previously, but the project does enjoy strong support from the Malawi government.
Absolutely. One of the sort of pillars of the Malawi government's economic wishes is to get the mining industry up and going in Malawi. There's a number of projects that are in development, and we're seeing really strong support from them. And at the moment, they have just put together their own technical committee to help permitting these projects through to production.
And so as far as moving things forward, the next step, so you'll be working closely with Rio to optimize some of these results.
Yeah, that's right. So we'll do a optimization study, taking into account all of the PFS results with our friends at Rio Tinto, and we will be, and then moving into the definitive feasibility study.
Given the demand supply, given the equation here for graphite and rutile, do you feel you're sitting with the right commodities here?
We do. It's an interesting mix. It's a unique mix of commodities, actually, but both industrial minerals, we see a extreme supply deficit in rutile at the moment, and that there are no operations on the horizon that will be able to fill that deficit. This project will be able to fill some of the deficit, but absolutely not all of it. So we're seeing really strong pricing in rutile at the moment. Iluka reported a recent shipment sold at around $1,900 US a tonne. For reference, we're using under $1,500 average in the study. And then in terms of graphite, that's predicted to go into supply deficit in 2024 due to the use of graphite in lithium ion battery anodes and obviously the growth of EVs and other uses of rechargeable batteries.
Hmm. Well, Julian, just a final thought, given the stage, given the milestone announced here with the pre-feasibility study for Kasiya, for prospective investors now perhaps looking to enter Sovereign Metals, how would you outline the investment case currently?
I'd outline the investment case as going, this is a deep value project, you know, something that's going to produce over 400 million US EBITDA a year for 25 years, modelled, and probably longer. It's very, very cheap.
Good to see you, Julian. Thanks for your time.
Great. Thanks, Andrew.